start from some information about the history of this place. So, our pillar is like first point. Pyramid was established in 1946 in the Piat settlement. Maybe you heard about Barentsburg, it's other Russian settlement here in Svalbard, but Barentsburg older, it was established in 1924 by a Dutch company. And in 1932, Soviet company Rosatomprom Kugel bought this settlement. And now Barentsburg is a live settlement. We have there 500 people working mine. But Pyramid and Younger, it was this place held at Swedish company since 1910 till 1927. In 1927, Soviet government bought this, and also a little bit later came the same company, Trastartikugel. Actually, this both settlement belonged to Russian company Trastartikugel. This company still exists, still governmental. It's kind of tricky way. It's actually Russian settlement, but this settlement don't belong, both of them don't belong to Russia directly. It belongs to Russian company. So, but company is government. They made this settlement and work in mine at the same time, only after Second World War, because it was a long time to bring all stuff to this place, because here nothing. You should bring everything actually for construction work, and also they had a break for war. And finally, in the 50s, in like 1950, we started to extract coal, and very soon this place became a very nice place for workers, for miners, and for other staff, because here people had very high salaries, they were provided by apartments, by food, for free. Actually, government supported very well. And Pyramid and Barentsburg also with a lot of money. But after USSR collapse, it became very hard for Russia to support this place. And because Russia got very strong financial crisis. And finally, company decided to conserve Pyramid. Exactly Pyramid, because this mine more expensive than in Barentsburg. It's harder to extract coal here. And also existed several other reasons. They decided to conserve, not leave. It's not abandoned, but build other constructions, later, mostly in that way. But they were provided very well by other staff, as like fabrics, different fabrics to produce different stuff here, not to bring from mainland. It's wooden fabric, brick fabric, so actually greenhouses, farms and other stuff to stay independent from mainland as much as it possible. So here we're able to see interesting mine. It's located upstairs. Two galleries go downstairs. Left was for miners, right was for coal. Inside special railway and by wagons, by trolley, they came upstairs and downstairs. Coal came downstairs also by special wagons. Actually, from mine existed special belt line directly to a power plant. Power plant is a pinky building with two coal chimneys, it's a power plant. Now it might work, of course. On it here you can see big metallic construction, also was for coal. Coal came from mine, one way to power plant, other way to here to cargo ship. Actually, it was one big system. On the way, in the middle, they had like coal storage. So, also about our pillar, you can see that the kind of interesting metallic construction is also from old pipes from water system. They changed water system and settlement in the 70s, and one from workers, from constructors, got idea to use some way old pipes, because it's like garbage now. And they made from pipes this metallic construction as art object, and now it's a symbol of Pyramid of our settlement. So, actually, we can continue way and next point in the heliport. Also, some of them experimented, but only this mountain has this name. So, actually, location of settlement also perfect. It's like open and flat area, and around mountains, and mountains protect us from wind, from strong wind. Of course, we have some wind, but not too strong as possible. Special pyramid and protect us from it from this side. Sometimes it's total quiet when around crazy winds. So here you can see kind of front line between industrial park and living park.
And next point will be a little house. It has name, nickname Vladka. So let's go. The company had 8 helicopters, and it was normal transport system. It was possible to bring everything from Barentsburg to Barentsburg. Actually, it was connection between Soviet settlements mostly. And people, mail, any stuff was possible to bring. Now for some stuff, we use cargo ship, own cargo ship from Barentsburg. For people, it's possible to come by private boats, by regular boats. So also it's possible to come by snowmobile, by snow scooter in winter time. It's like orange bricks, but it's just decoration. Originally they made from slag blocks. Actually, they, people had here factory of slag blocks, as I told. That be filled with slag. It's solid slag. And it was very nice way to save money and energy to produce construction stuff here and to bring from mainland. And we don't see some buildings. Decoration by wood and decoration by bricks. So behind London you can see our hotel Pyramiden. Now all life is inside.